The Kremlin is a favorite place for walking for the residents and visitors of Nizhny Novgorod. If you ask the youngest ones what place in the Kremlin they like the most, they will, of course, name the exhibition of military equipment between the Dmitrovskaya and Kladovaya towers. It is so interesting there. The T-34 tank, the legendary Katyusha, armored cars, guns. You can touch them, climb them, take pictures. Once, a formidable weapon of war has become a landmark. And, of course, a symbol of pride of Nizhny Novgorod, our city has made a huge contribution to the production of weapons of victory. During the Second World War, the Nizhnogorodsky Kremlin, as in times of troubles, took part in the fight for the liberation of the country. On the heights of the Severnaya, the Tainitskaya and the Chesovaya towers, after dismantling the roof, anti-aircraft installations were placed. They did not allow the enemy aircraft to break through the city. The citizens formed the groups of people militia.
During the Great Patriotic War, the city of Gorky made a significant contribution to the defense of the city from enemy raids and to the defense of the entire country, becoming one of the main arsenals of the front, its closest military industrial base. The role of the city on the Volga in the defense of the capital of our country, Moscow, was particularly significant. In October 1941, the Gorky region became a frontline region. The Gorky City Defense Committee was organized on the 23rd of October 1941.
In early October, the residents of Nizhny Novgorod remembered the labor feat performed during the Second World War. The region was a huge hospital rear point. There are more than 400,000 soldiers and commanders of the Red Army were treated. The first military sanitary train arrived in Gorky on 11th July. Schools, institutes, dormitories, they converted into hospitals. There was a hospital in the Palace of Labor as well. The sacrifice of Gorky's rear is also a feat. The collective farmers, though starving themselves, provided the wounded with food. The enemy will not pass. That was the motto of those who worked selflessly at the construction of defensive lines. All necessary measures were taken to make the city an impregnable fortress.
On the Kremlin wall, between the Dmitrovskaya and Prokhorovaya towers, is a plaque in memory of military units and formations formed on the Nizhnogorodskaya land during the Second World War, including rifle divisions, tank, artillery, fighter anti-tank brigades, mechanized corps, and river ship brigades. The 31st Special Division of Armored Trains, Aviation, and Engineering Regiments, Platoon Bridge Battalion. The memory of military and labor feats of Gorkovchan will remain in our hearts forever.